Hello, besties. I want to go ahead and do a reading just solely on love. So if you're interested, stick around. We're going to go ahead and use three decks. We're going to start out for tarot. Then we're going to jump to La Roche's Goddess Queen Just Me 23's deck. And then we're going to bring it home with our lovely Angel Answers Oracle that I did not take out of its container until now. So we're gonna see what comes out. What are we vibing with? What's our love life gonna look like for the next 2 weeks? Make sure you go ahead, like, subscribe, comment for engagement. Really helps your girl out. And you're entered to win a free personal. I select three people the first of every month or around the first. And you get a private one-on-one reading with me. The only private readings I do. So let's go ahead and get started. Take a deep breath in through the nose. Out through the mouth, putting good energy into the cards. God, energy source, your ancestors and mine, because we are energetically aligned. What do we need to go ahead and know for the next 2 weeks in love, please? And thank you, spirit. What do we need to know? We'll take those. Ooh, we got the Hierophant. So Taurus energy represent marriage potential, longevity, you know, shared values, knowledge, beliefs, everything you want and more. And then we got the Queen of Pentacles. You could be coming out as the Queen of Pentacles. And really, this is abundance. So abundance to me is health, wealth, prosperity, love, gratitude. This is Virgo energy. So we only have Earth sign energy on the table. Also, the Hierophant is fives. So fives are all about change and really standing in your power. Be careful if you want to go ahead and get pregnant. I mean, the Queen of Pentacles, it represents fertility to some degree. So if you don't want that, maybe pump the brakes. But really, that's standing in your creative power. And, you know, someone who's capable of being a mother figure, gender doesn't matter. But since it's the Queen of Pentacles, just going to use that. A mother figure and a businesswoman. You kind of have it all balanced out. You're very, like, sexual, sensitive, sensual. I meant sensual, not sexual. Sensual. And really, you have this, you know, nurturing energy about you. And with the moon in reverse, you're releasing all this fear, all this anxiety out here. Potentially releasing, like, you know, any self-deprecation that you might have going on, any beliefs that you're not good enough, any illusions, things like that. Secrets are coming to light, bestie. Let's go ahead and see what else comes out for our love life. Well, we got the Empress. So a lot of Earth sign energy only on the board at this point in time. But really, once again, another fertility card. But this is really embodying the divine feminine, leading with your heart space, really stepping into that power and understanding exactly what you want. You're very nurturing and things around you are just going to be harmonious and flow, honestly. With the Hangman, after a period of feeling like you're trapped, it's kind of like the Wheel of Fortune is turning in your favor. Let's see what else comes out. Yeah, we have lovely the Three of Wands. So you're moving forward. You got that confidence, potential travel, Aries energy, having success, making choices, and being happy about the outcome. Your life is definitely paying off in your favor. A Knight of Wands might come in, Sagittarius energy, so only fire and earth on this table so far, but they're going to make a quick decision. They're going to come in fast, they're very ambitious, and you feel like you might have a lot to offer this person. Just be careful that they, you know, aren't quick in, quick out, and not offering you what you want. But I think this person might come in very quickly and have a lot of that passion. But at the bottom of the deck, we have the Chariot. So sevens are all about divine timing, divine protection, overcoming what you need to overcome, balance coming in, having that control, that self-discipline, that hard work, and that focus coming your way. Right below that, we have the King of Cups and the Emperor. So definitely someone who is emotionally intelligent, offers good advice, is very tapped in, is aware, cares about your feelings. It's a mature, emotionally stable person. And then especially with the Emperor right below, they could be transitioning into this power as soon as, or this state of mind, as soon as, you know, you go ahead and get grounded in your life as well. They want to go ahead and give you that stability. And I mean, we have a divine counterparts here. So either a soulmate, a twin flame kind of connection, but definitely someone who is going to lead more logically, but it's definitely a perfect pair. Splitting the deck, the final outcome. Yeah, we have lovely the four of swords or five of swords in reverse. So there's going to be a peaceful resolution. Maybe you're moving on from someone in the past. This is a new person. Communication is right around the corner. Ending of conflict, splitting the deck again. Yes, we have the three of swords in reverse. So you're really releasing that pain, overcoming your boundaries and like overcoming depression, anxiety, being optimistic and really ready to jump into this full energy and allow yourself to, you know, have that spontaneity, go with the flow, and really have that freedom. There's new beginnings coming. Splitting the deck again, we have the lovely five of wands in reverse. So that's, once again, end of conflict, reaching your agreement, compromise. So someone who's definitely going to come into your life and give you that equal give and take and make you realize why other things have not worked out. Right below that, I can't make this shit up. The Lover's card. We should cover that. The Lover's card. So this is definitely a soulmate, a spiritual connection. You are definitely guided into each other's life for a reason. And really, it's that equal give and take, that potential to lead to long term, right? Actually, let's get one more. You're already trusting your intuition. You're following through on this. You already know. The more you release and stop trying to control the who, what, when, where, why, the universe is going to come in. You already have been getting these signs, synchronicities that someone's coming in, and bestie, they are. But let's go ahead and get some more clarification with LaRoche's Goddess Queen, Just Me 23's deck, and see if we can get some more answers on our love life here in the next 2 weeks. What do we need to expect in our love life in the next 2 weeks? Did I not tell you this? Okay, well, first and foremost, you're protected. So just know that by God, the universe, your ancestors, whoever you believe in is protecting you, looking out for you. And they're really putting the pedal to the metal on this person. This person's getting a lot of signs and synchronicities about you. They went through a spiritual awakening, a spiritual ascension. They realize what this connection is, where they want to take it. They've been getting a lot of signs. So whether that's your car, numbers, you know, feeling like they see your name everywhere, they smell your perfume, your cologne, and they know that they're gonna miss their chance here soon because you're unique. This is my Rihanna card, shine bright like a diamond, you're one of a kind, shine bright even if it hurts their eyes. And time is a ticking. They know if they don't come forward, express their feelings here soon, they're gonna miss their chance because you got a lot of options coming in with the entanglement card. Past life lovers, new lovers here to challenge your masculine or your feminine. Did I not say you're very intuitive? Third eye chakra. So you've been getting these visions out here, you know, figuring out who this person is. Is this person really going to come forward? That was too many, spirit. Let's see. Anything else we need to know for the next 2 weeks? Well, did I not say you're getting that person who is that emperor energy, moving into that energy with the life partner union, something that's long-standing, longevity, we love to see, and it's your soulmate. We come together for a purpose. You recognize me. At the bottom of the deck, yeah, they want me to keep this on the low. I mean, it's one of those things. They're not ready to be vulnerable yet, and I'm cracking the code. I'm spilling the tea. Call me Kermit the Frog. Ribbit, ribbit, bitch. But they want to come in a union with you. So let's celebrate. Let's turn up parties just because. I want to spend all my time with you, give you the energy that you deserve. You just need to stop doubting yourself. Stop doubting this connection. Fear, I'm not good enough for you. You're not good enough for me. Bestie, they are lucky to be in your presence. Splitting the deck, final outcome. Yeah, this person went through a diet change. Doesn't normally have to be change in diet, but change in morals, values, ideals. Splitting the deck again. They're watching you. Will you be mine? My family and friends are my spies. I know what you're doing. Fake accounts. Yeah, that's because they got their karma when they walked away from you. Maybe they ghosted you. Maybe they weren't ready for a relationship. Now they're dealing with backstabbers. Hosts smile in your face the whole time they want to take your place. But they've been deep in their feels, nostalgia, missing you. I don't think this is a toxic energy by any means. But it's definitely something that false started that never felt like it had the full beginning to fully get going. And with that, in it to win it, in it to lose it, my soul contract says so. And then right below that is, once again, earth sign energy. You can have whatever you like, king or queen of pentacles, Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus coming out. They want to be your provider. So they want to be your provider. Great. Yeah. like I said, it's divine timing coming in, interjecting this and doing a lot of work behind the scenes to bring this together, because your ancestors, them, God, the universe is literally slaying hoes behind the scenes, removing karmics from your life, their life, and really trying to push this connection coming forward. But the human experience is all about emotions and feeling your emotions and honestly having free will. So you're able to make your own decision, but I'm saying this is looking good. We got divine counterparts out here, but let's go ahead and read with the Romance Angels Oracle. See what else we need to know and love for the next 2 weeks here, please. And thank you, Spirit. Yeah. Okay, so like I said, there was deception. I'm really leaning towards there's deception about their feelings. Someone's wearing a false mask in this relationship, and it's one of those things. Wedding came out. Once again, longevity, stability. This situation involves marriage. I mean, let's walk before we can run, be in a relationship, get engaged, enjoy the moment. But I think you're honestly going ahead. I can pick up the damn card. You're letting go of control issues. So you got to release the control and allow the situation to unfold naturally. So if it's divine timing, I say that at 11:11 on the clock, it's one of those things you have to go ahead, pray about it, release any outcomes, any expectations, and let's see what else comes forward. Anything else for the next 2 weeks, please and thank you, Spirit. Chemistry, yes, there's a magnetic attraction here. And then at the bottom of the deck is passion. So allow your heart to sing and soul to sing with joy, and free yourself is below this. So it's time to take control back of your life. You know, you're in control of your thoughts, emotions, and reactions. It's just up to you to rewire that subconscious. Think about the glass half full mentality. You're allowed to have a bad day, but rewire that. Don't allow it to manifest. And that's because you deserve love. So I'm just telling you, you are lovable. You do deserve this. And then this is a true love. So yeah, this is definitely a romance of a lifetime. It was meant to be. You have that soul contract with each other because you are a soulmate. And I'm just letting you know, new love. So like I was saying, I don't feel like this is someone completely new. Maybe it's someone you false started with, but it's definitely not someone you have a long ass history with, because we have at the bottom of the deck, or continuing on, is release your ex. So like I was saying, clear your energy from that false twin flame and move forward to get this divine counterpart, because I'm telling you, it's worth waiting for. Divine timing's at play. Splitting the deck, final outcome. Let's go here. Make the effort. Exactly. Great love is worth taking the steps you're guided to take. Splitting the deck again. Romantic feelings. Your feelings are real and worth exploring. They feel the exact same way you do, and we love to see that out here. Great news, great vibes, and I'm going to hit you with a surprise. If you made it this far, comment a butterfly in the chat, or in the comments below, not in the chat, but in the comments below, and I'm going to do Rebel Oracle. This really doesn't have to deal with love. Maybe it does, but it has savage messages that like to cuss us out, and I want to give you a special treat. So, Spirit, what do we need to know? The savage truths for the next 2 weeks, please and thank you. What the hell are you waiting for? Get that shit done. If you're looking for a sign, well, here the fuck it is. Let's see what else comes out. What do we need to know? Yeah, ask a fucking expert. Don't rely on your friends or the internet. Listen to a damn professional. Exactly. Heal those issues. You know, go to therapy, journal, meditate, go on hot girl walks, do whatever makes you feel grounded. Take those 5 to 10 minutes of yourself and possibly go take a trip. As long as money allows it, your health allows it, go see some shit, do some new things, talk to people cooler than you. And at the bottom of the deck, we have make better fucking choices. If you're pissed at where you're at, then stop taking yourself there. Exactly. Stop taking that ex back. The definition of insanity is doing something over and over again and expecting a different result. And did I not say that? It said, it's dark and you can't see a fucking thing. Splitting the deck. Get your head out of your ass pronto. Mood. And then it says, drop the fucking ego. Vulnerability's hot as fuck. I think this is for your person. They need to be honest about their emotions. And you need to get the fuck out of your head and get in your heart, because it misses you. So I love you so much, besties. Thank you for being here. I hope you have a fabulous week. Whenever you see this, it is timeless, but this was meant to find you when it did. And subscribe to be entered to win that free personal. Those are the only personals I do. All you have to do, you can comment on this video and just be subscribed. We're almost to 1,000 followers, and I couldn't do it without you, besties. You deserve the world. You are a queen. You are a king. And don't let anyone dull your shine, because you're a bad bitch and you're a bad king and you deserve the world. I refuse to let my besties get breadcrumbed or get half-assed in any situation. So I love you. And until next time, bye.